Everything is before God. And nothing is before God. The truest enlightened state is absolute statelessness, merging with all states to become total zero life, beyond life. Where everything goes, God goes, world goes, Buddha, Shiva, job, family, all go. Even you go. All these things that go. Which is everything that goes. Have names. Can be spoken of. Can be seen, some touched, some can be heard, but all of what is spoken goes, all mind goes. Everything that goes all of this is mind-based knowledge, and when life comes back in its purest empty state. Deep and profound rebirth, reemerges, and to cope, with this rebirth, a selective mind is allowed to resurface as you again. The world simply moves. Everything appears to come and go. It may appear to your mind and to others that you are participating, but you're simply the witness. Of everything coming and going. Once the senses begin to work again, and words appear from your mouth, I found God. I recognized self. It was Brahman. I met Shiva. Whatever comes is simply mind was done in to summarize and provide names. These names are placed in front of you through a mind that knows. It gives you its knowing towards what you experienced. Because mind was not there. It tries to summarize and assume and wonder what it was by using the words that recognize what it would like to have been. All or nothingness, same thing, has no individual name. So the enlightened consciousness that resurfaced from this zero life cannot speak or describe or visualize about what, where, who, or when it took place. Therefore, this human mind, so that it can ground you back to earth to help you, the body and mind, resume with human organized life. It categorizes through what it knows, names, descriptions, analysis, so that when this re-merging takes place, the real you, the true, pure you, feels the always still total experience, accompanied by mind blurbing out names that it loves to show it cares. And the names it gives to your wordless experience is the names that all are inspired and overawed by. Example: I met Christ, the Holy Spirit. I found self. I heard the voice of God. I recognize Rumi's words as what I experienced. But in truth, every explanation is exactly the same. The mind uses words. The true you only recognizes the pure consciousness which is the ultimate. And encompasses every word, including Brahman, God, within it. But even to give the name consciousness is a type of blasphemy, because words cannot describe that what is. Beyond consciousness that stretches infinitely, limitlessly, effortlessly, forever. Beyond and within, and in every place that mind gives names to, is the owner of this consciousness that you become. Papaji calls it the mystery. Another word to try and describe even beyond the wordless. I call it beyondness. Pureness. Nothingness. Another few words to describe the wordless. Best is not to speak, but to simply reflect what is. Be the beacon, the permanent stillness, and let everything with names come through you, whatever you are. You will experience all these words in consciousness, and consciousness in its purest state. Tranquil love, forever and ever, even when the body goes. You are that what is. Only one moment to discover what is, and only one moment reveals itself to what is. One moment are the two words that stops everything in its tracks to reveal zero life, before life, beyond life, and total life. When this one moment begins again, allows you to take your place in a body on earth with mind. Its job has been done. The mystery has not revealed itself the beyondness, the here-ness, the nothingness has not revealed itself. It always stays within a distance of what it loves. One moment is the moment that all came together to create this and that. One moment is what Buddha says being was born. Consciousness enshrouds and loves this one moment. The mystery, nothingness, stillness enshrouds this one moment, and one moment is when your life began. And will never end.